So thank you, Uli, for being one more time with us at Canal Recipes. You have been a famous speaker for us several times, and now you are also a good attendee. So we would love to make in this video helping people understanding who you are, what was your history regarding the Linux kernel, how you went into the Linux area, and what's your passion around it. So my first question is, what's your history with the kernel and how you went into it?
It started around 1994. I was a student. I was using DOS exclusively by then. And a friend showed me this at the university. I discovered Linux. I'd never heard about it prior to this. And by this time, it was a kernel 1.06, I guess, and distributed and with a system distributed using diskettes. It was not much portable. The hardware support was very limited, and by then, the recommended way to support your hardware was to edit the C files and modify the network card addresses by hand and rebuild. So at least it's a good lesson, because you enter very quickly in it. And kernel 1.0 was so small that it was very easy to have a global view of it very quickly. So that's how I started, and since I've always been a hardware guy, every time I was hacking on some various hardware controllers or whatever, for me it was completely natural, I would say, to just modify a few bits in a driver just to adapt it to what I was doing, even if it was completely unrelated, just mostly by laziness. I started like this. Much later, maybe 2 years later, I submitted my first patch to properly detect my CRX CPU. I remember it was merged by Linus. By then there was no version control, whatever. He accepted it. I was very proud. When you are a newcomer and your first patch is accepted, you're proud of it. And 1 week later, it was reverted and replaced by another one by Ingo. And I started to realize how it worked. And in fact, it gives a good incentive to upstream quickly and to participate to the mailing list, to be aware of what is being done, what people are working on, to avoid conflicting areas, or to participate to discussions instead of doing the job twice. And later, much later, in fact, I started really to use Linux everywhere, on my home machines, on firewalls that I later put to customers, on a server I maintained at the university, in fact, everywhere. And when you deploy Linux everywhere, you start to have your own set of patches and to tailor it to your needs. And I started to maintain my own set of fixes during 2.4, because there was no concept of stable version during 2.4. So every single upgrade brought some bug fixes and some new issues. It was quite painful. So I had this hotfix tree. And when Marcelo Tosati took over the maintenance of this version, I exchanged with him, providing some of my patches that were relevant to this branch. And we got used to exchange a lot. Sometimes he used to send me an email saying, "Hey, Willie, I'm going to release next week. Do you have some patches pending?" And when he decided to move to something else, he proposed me to take over his maintenance. I was completely terrified. First by the responsibility, and second by the process and whatever it means. And in fact, he has been really cool. He helped me a lot, doing some of the initial work behind the curtains for me, and me doing it for him. So we worked in tandem for maybe 3 to 6 months. He helped me a lot. Introduced me to the security list. It was not yet the security list. I think it was VendorSec only at this time, or maybe I was on the 2. I don't remember. But I discovered all these maintenance world like this just by being introduced by a peer, I would say, And by the way, he was almost elected the same way. So for him, it was probably more natural. So I started like this, and by continuing to use these stable kernels that I used to maintain for a very long time for my own usage and for the products I used to deliver to customers, it became natural to continue to maintain them. So there is nothing fancy, as you can see.
Oh, by the way, it could be pretty impressive for many people that never did it by themselves, and as you were, just being scared about the unknown part of the Linux kernel. And what would be your advice for the newcomers that would love to be maybe on the same track, or which are just in the state that you were, just being impressed? What would be your recommendation to help them passing the gap on starting to be active and to take their place into this big world, which have grown a lot since the time you've been there?
I think it depends a lot on the people themselves, but starting by trying to address bugs that are relevant to their usage is the first gap, because it gives incentive. When you have something which does not work, you have a good incentive to put your nose in the code and to follow a single chain, because the code paths are very, very long now. It's very hard to follow everything. There are macros everywhere, inline functions. It's difficult to follow for a newcomer. But if you focus only on a problem that affects you, ultimately you either find the problem, or you have no idea how to fix it, but you locate the area. And in both cases, from this point, you can contact the relevant system maintainers, the driver's authors, you can post on various mailing lists. And if a maintainer sees that a newcomer has done his homework, there is never any single problem. And these people are respected, and they give a good help to maintainers, because it's very difficult for a maintainer to spend a lot of time reproducing whatever bug anyone reports. And when you realize that someone helps and wants to help, is willing to run some bisect, to rebuild, to reboot, to provide traces, in fact, it's a huge help. So these people will quickly be respected, and even if their first submission or question maybe a bit awkward initially because they don't know the process, after their first patch is merged, for them it will become much easier, and for some it may become even addictive.
Okay, quickly about your future, what are your new project or new challenges that you are foreseeing? What are on your list of the things to be done?
For the kernel?
For anything of kernel maybe, but maybe some other personal project, or?
I don't know. I've been spending the last almost 20 years maintaining very old stuff. So in fact, I'm quite conservative. When I have something which works and I don't need more, I stick to it. So I hardly look forward to jump on new stuff. So that's the reason why I continue to maintain old kernels, for example. So that's really it. So it's hard to get an ID. I can switch to another LTS kernel, at least because I use them in our products at my company. So I will take over them if nobody picks them. But I have no special plans, in fact, for the future. For me, the situation is fine like this. I have done some few experiments on various stuff that I presented here a few years ago, like network optimization or whatever. But in fact, I realized I don't have the time to work much on this. So if I can just draft the ideas, just put some numbers that I measured, share them with people who have more time, it's already good for me.
So thank you, Willy, for accepting this interview. Thank you also for being a big support since the beginning on the initial stage of Kernel Recipes. It's a fantastic journey that we are spending all together. So thank you a lot for helping us. And I'm sure that we'll meet again at the next edition of Kernel Recipes. Thank you.
I agree as well. And thank you for creating Kernel Recipes, because I know you are the initiator. And thanks for this.
Thank you, Willy.